Perhaps what I'd like to do is maybe, because we are running a bit short on, we did start late, so what we'll do is also finish a little bit late. Maybe we'll move quickly on to chapter four, and obviously we're around after for questions and answers as well. If you look at operational infrastructure, I think here we do see quite a lot of blacked out because obviously it's very specific to names, but so page 21 onwards. I think one of the key issues here, you know, who are the key people involved? How do they interact? And this is also, although talking to the key people during the process is important, I think it's also a very important way to try to talk to some of the junior staff to see how they interact with the senior people, because you also get the impression then, are they being overruled in some cases? Do you have a strong authority power in the organisation who's seen as the god in that institution? So I think that's one of the key things. But then, similarly, also, if you look at the key people, is there a key man risk there, for example, as well? Is there a team spirit? Is there a broad group of well-experienced people, and do they work in a team? So that's also part of it. And then you also want to look at their backgrounds as well. So one of the key things is also to check the backgrounds of some of the key people.
I mean, interestingly, chapter four for many people is ODD. Right, remember I was talking about silos earlier. Chapter four is key operation staff, front office, back office, reconciliation, IT, backups. For many people, that's ODD. For us, as you can see, it's chapter four. Unfortunately, it's only a bit of it. But it's very telling. It's very telling in relation to, again, how people have approached certain, if you take the BCP, it's your risk management culture. How serious is this? How does it work? Are tests being done? It's very easy to verify this. You don't need to spend hours on this. Hello, do you have a BCP? So yes, I do. No, I don't. We do that pre-on site. And then the BCP says, I back up my tapes every week. I have a tape system. I have another system. And when we get to on site, we say, can we see the server? Can we see the tapes? Right? In this particular manager, I remember very, very well that the first time we did it, there were no tapes. And they got so upset about this because they said, of course we have tapes. We're the biggest bank in the world and so forth. But they didn't have tapes. They had it every year after that, or at least when we did our visit.
Well, the second year, if I remember correctly, they said they had tapes. But actually, they backed them up and they put them on the shelf above.
Oh, yes, there was that as well.
So
they stayed. The tapes stayed there.
Fire, it was still going to be an issue. So obviously, in a case like that, you'd want to make sure they've got remote backups.
There are very important points in this. Insurance is also a standard or not. Do you have to have insurance at the level of the DNO? Is it at the level of PI? How much insurance? There's no standard on this. So you have to make up your own. We look for a percentage of AUM to make sure that it makes sense. It's a funny thing, but insurance hasn't really picked up in this industry, so you have quite a few insurance brokers who are still, heavily trying to sell insurance to managers. It's just not compulsory. Now we've seen that with new regulatory changes, it's something that's going to become more relevant. But,
also making sure that the right entity has signed and paid for the insurance as well.
Correct, and also sometimes it's, because again, you need to see the insurance certificate. Easy to check, isn't it? It's one thing. And the insurance certificate will have the name of a company. But if you're into holding co's and subsidiaries, is it listed? Is it named? People forget that. So to do that, you need to know insurance. So happens that we do. But we're not necessarily the best experts, but we understand it, so we know what to look for. And very often, I think a business manager doesn't. So he's got PI, but it's only for a company that's actually not relevant. Or he forgot to name the other companies. And this matters to you.
Or they launch a new company and
forget to add it.
TER
at 4.4, you see that again. We talked about it earlier. So we looked at it separately, and we're looking at it again here. In this instance, nothing untoward, but we're breaking it down, trying to understand it. So I didn't completely hear. You said the custody and administration fees. You're saying how do we measure if this is standard or above, especially because they're all related?
Yes.
Yeah, so again, I mean, this is where it becomes a bit touchy-feely. So 22 and 6 bips is probably fine, actually quite below some of the other prices in administration. Custody appears, in my view here, a bit high. Do we start, it's not 50 bips, so it's probably not a breach of a standard. We already highlighted a red flag on the link between the two companies. I think at some point our client has to do what you've just done, which is 22, 6, they're all linked, is that too much? It also gives you a measure of potential negotiation if you're doing an investment managed account. I don't know, it's hard to answer that. On this particular one, I don't have a breach or a concern. I think this is high. I don't know, what did we write? Did we say it was high? No, we just stated them as a fact.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But again, but that's, I think, more to do with, you know, if you're an investment manager and then do negotiate discounts or not, understanding the fact that they also make money here as well, as a group. So, and maybe thinking, okay, maybe they're not always the best
execution. In custody, this is a sort of private type bank. And so, you know, you also have to look at this. I think you could kill those custody fees, if you ask me. But this is where we have that red flag earlier. We also try not to repeat the red flags everywhere in a way that it would, you know, concentrate on one point, because otherwise it would floor what I hope the red flag is useful for. But you would pick this up.